up, you guys? We're here in No Time, No Problem with, again, the special guest, Giovanni.
What's up?
I won't do the jump roll because I think I scared him last time. So we'll just go, la 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 la.
Is that like some fairy dust being sprinkled
over
me?
Yeah, if I could do that, like little fairies, and they'd be like kissing you all over the cheek.
Hey, I'm not going to pose it out. I'm not posing it.
And then you would be in the Peter Pan tights and... Oh, okay, that's a different story. So... Oh my goodness. So since we have you back, we have to get deep inside. What have you been up to since last time I talked to you?
Man, just still working on the music, man. Gotten up with a new great songwriter by the name of Nick Wells.
Nice.
Been working with just a little bit of everybody. Got some big features that I'm about to do some stuff with. I ain't gonna say who yet. Yeah, you know.
So, okay, because last time you were here now, you had Comeback. That was your thing. So now you are working on something else, working with the same people with Comeback?
No, different producers. Okay. Just anybody that has been, I've been blessed. A lot of people come up to me saying, yo, I heard Comeback. I mess with it, man. Like, yo, man, I do beats. I do music, man.
Nice.
So a lot of people want to work. So I'm blessed and happy about that.
How do you feel now? Because I know last time that I talked to you, you were saying that it was not new to you coming back with music, but are you feeling more comfortable on, like, you know what, I'm going to go full in on this year?
I got so many friends that it's still hard for people to take my music seriously because I'm the funny guy.
Yeah.
So sometimes I doubt it. I doubt myself. I get a little scared. And, you know, I feel like, you know, nobody's ever going to take me serious, but I have. Blessedly, I say I have some real friends that say, no, man, make them believe. Like, you dope.
So it's Giovanni, yes!
So, you know, I'm going through it. I'm just going to do an EP for right now.
Now, besides singing, you guys, now, I've seen this clip on his Instagram with the whole, what is it, called the mic?
Mm-hmm.
Yes, dancing. The boy can dance, get down. I mean, oh, do that little roll, just a little to the side and then
what
to the
hell
other
is
side.
That? Chocolate City Kitchen Edition.
Oh, talking about that. Yeah, what's going on with that? Hold up. Thought Magic, Mike, let's talk about that.
I did that to her earlier. She's gonna lose it back over.
That Carmel City. Let's go ahead and aka chocolate.
One, I gained weight. I'm fat from the last time you saw me. I gained about 15 pounds. But I can't say yet, man. I can't say yet. I can't say yet.
Okay.
It might be a yeah, it might be a no.
Right. You know.
But forget, you know, I've danced professionally for about 9 years with major artists, so dancing has always been in my blood.
That's nothing to you. Okay.
I do a little sun in the bedroom for my lady at the time, if I have a girl at the time.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm. Girl, you don't want none of this. Tell you something. You be walking sideways.
You
can see the camera person's face.
Talking about we'll go a little bit on the wrong section. Talking about the bedroom, what would be your favorite song to jam to? Would it be your own song? To woo the lady? Or would it be something?
It'd be like on some Sade, Anita Baker.
Okay.
That's what I'll, you know.
So, are you that kind of man that likes with the rose petals and all? If it's that special lady,
if it's that special lady, man, I go all out.
Are you the one that stands in the door with the boxers and the draw?
No, man, I like to play games, you know. I like to give clues, you know.
Oh.
Go to this door. Then once you unlock that door, I want you to count back from 10. Once you count back from 10, divide that by 5.
Ooh.
Go in the refrigerator and get 5 eggs. Crack one open. There's a note in there. Like, I'm on some other stuff. You know, then you finally get in the room. I'm just there, butt-ass naked with some Jordans on.
Nice. Oh, my God. Well, with that being said, I know the last time, which was amazing. I had an amazing interview, you guys, with Giovanni. The last time... how do you feel being just from there to now, going into the holidays, going into 2016, what have you learned just even from the couple months? Going into, what do you want to do going into 2016 that you've learned from 2015? That you're not either taking or taking with you?
The biggest thing I want to do and cross over to 2016 is to have more patience. To think logically and not emotionally. And to not argue, just let things go. whatever it's meant to be is gonna be.
And that is true.
The biggest thing I've done this year probably was stress. I stress so much. You know, stress can cause a lot of physical symptoms. Mm-hmm. Like I was having chest pains, headaches, lightheadedness, throwing up, all due and been in the emergency room. Doc said you're perfectly fine. You just need to reduce your stress. And I'm 29, so that's the biggest thing to 2016 is to do not to stress,
Okay.
and to be more at peace.
Yes, that's good. I think that's the biggest thing that everybody deals with is hella stress. So that's good to go into that year with that. I also seen you do something very funny with Alpha Cat. And that was something with the whole Obama what was it? It was like a whole video of him pretty much doing drinks back to back, but you guys were freaking hilarious.
Thank you, man. This is my second time working with him. I've been on for years, but this is my second parody of Barack I've done with him. The first one was actually requested from President Barack Obama for Obama Healthcare. So that's why he did it. It's he parodied Snoop, Drop It Like It's Hot. And then this one was the Drake parody back to back, and he called me and Splack up, the original two security dudes, because you know we just gonna make it funny, and we did it. And it's they always go viral. Like his parodies are getting played on MSNBC and CNN. Like they're talking about this parody like it's people saying it's better than Meek Mill's diss.
No, now that's big. That diss was
garbage.
Oh my gosh. Well. Let us know right now, are you still single? Because I know in the industry, a little bit of time has gone by. And I know things can change, some things don't. What it really is? Da 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 da!
I'm dating my career right now.
Now that's a good answer. Damn, I was thinking it was about to be thrown out, and then the career was just like right there. Hey, there's nothing wrong with that. Being focused, staying focused.
I'm dating my career right now.
Okay.
You know,
that's good.
There is someone that's dear to me, but, you know, that's just to keep me focused on dating my career.
Okay, nothing wrong with that at all. Okay, Giovanni, well, what do you have coming up next that people can look out for?
Well, I had a Lifetime movie out. Right now on the Lifetime movie channel called Dangerous Company. And then, like I said, Every Time Restored Me, I can't wait for that. That's next year. And I'm pending for some things. So I'm really just right now just in the kitchen. I'm cooking right now. I'm cooking. You know, this is my Beyonce take 2 years off moment. So, you know, waiting on the next job. But, excuse me. Edit that. I'm cooking right now. I'm just really focused on the music right now because that's the thing I can really resort to every day. And opposed to acting and comedy, you know, I'm in the studio every single day.
Wow.
And I can't wait, man. I can't wait.
That's awesome. Like, being in the studio, taking most of your time, does it affect relationships? Like, being able, whether it's for friends, and do people understand that?
Absolutely, it affects it. Of course, when it's from somebody, if it doesn't affect, if it's from someone who understands and knows, but you know, a lot of these women out here don't really know what it's like. So, you know, a lot of women or men, they want to be selfish. Why you got to be in the studio till 2 a.m? Why you got to go here? Why?
It's a sacrifice.
Well, you know, it's a sacrifice. But you know, like I say, I'm doing music because I love music. It's always been a passion. I'm not trying to win Grammys or nothing. Like, I'm just, my grandmother always teaches me not to marginalize myself. So if I feel like anything I can do, I'm gonna attempt it. And I got a crazy team that's gonna make sure I deliver a great product.
That's awesome. I have one more request. You know, last time we had to talk about our old school and we brought up meeting in my bedroom. Mm-hmm. Now.
What time?
Now, what Joe song do you know? That's like my thing right now.
Joe. Man, Joe is a beast, man. Ooh. My boy Jamal H2O put me, I used to hate Joe. I used to think, but he put me on one of Joe albums like 2-3 years ago, and I was a Joe fan ever since, man.
What's your favorite song?
Oh, man, I can't. He had these two albums that just came out back to back, and both was amazing. I can't remember none of the songs on that thing.
Oh.
I just remember it being hot. I wanna know what this is.
Make it look. last forever.
Is that Joe?
Yes, that's Joe. Yeah, with Mariah Carey.
Oh, yeah.
See, oh! And I'm 28.
It's the way you sang it. It sounded a little cute sweatish.
Okay.
Yeah, you made it sound like cute sweatish.
I don't know. Okay.
But Joe did sing that.
Yes. Yeah. See? I know about my Joe. Now, I don't know, you know about Genuine.
Oh, they used to call me Geno Wine in high school, in junior high. Because I used to, I looked up to Genuine so much. When he had the curls, I had the curls. When he took it and turned them into braids, I turned them shits into braids. For real. And I won my talent show off What's So Different.
Oh, gosh. We have the Marreño y Puertorriqueño.
See?
So we have that pretty much, that kind of Genuine. I mean.
That's right. And people say I look like him, and I don't see it. And people say I look like David Otunga, Jennifer Hudson's husband. I get that.
Yes.
I don't look like this, nigga.
Yes!
Mm-mm.
Get your little lawyer suit, you got it.
Hey, come on, I'm trying to touch up my titties,
man. Oh my gosh. Well, for our Halloween special tonight, Giovanni, tell them where you're gonna be at tonight.
I am hosting at 801 Hill down street. 801 Hill, damn, I think it was. I'm hosting at 801 Hill Street. It's an 80s rewind, downtown LA. Shout out to Myron Minton, I'm hosting that. But before that, I think I'm gonna stop by your party.
Oh.
Here.
No Time No Problem is having a party tonight. Mm-hmm. So that would be amazing if you stop by. We would love that. We've made amazing food and drinks.
Yes.
So if you come ghouling into the door, then maybe, you know.
Hey, I'm gonna come as a vampire, so I have to ask my permission to come in. Shout out to Soppy, man. I love her. She's married.
Aww.
She's hot, man.
Ow!
Both of y'all can get it.
Oh my gosh.
I'm saying everything now that I know is not going to make it.
Giovanni. Oh my goodness. Well, we are constantly going to have Giovanni on. We love him.
Yes, I'm coming back with Don.
Oh, okay.
I'm going to come with Don.
Okay. Awesome. And it's going to be the crazy.
Light skin. You got to make light skin dishes. Light skin, like DNA. That's our crew. DNA is called them niggas attractive.
Oh my gosh. Yeah. That episode, you guys be on the lookout for it. That's Oh my gosh. Yay. Well, thank you so much for coming back, Giovanni.
Thank you for having me.
This time we're not getting a chance to dance with him, but we will next time.
Yes.
Because last time we had a full music video. He's worth it.
Whole music video. Okay,
next time, hopefully, we have your song out.
Hey, the words of Denzel Washington, if there's a next time, I guarantee a correct amount that we're going to have a good time. Hey, no time, no problem. They tried to cook my food.
Oh my gosh, stay tuned, you guys. This is Giovanni. No Time, No Problem. Dale, gracias. Halloween special.
No problem. Yes. My little green shoppy up in here. Listen, they can cook their ass off.
Yes.
Hold on.
Dale. Ooh. I knew you would do that. You know who his brother is right there? That little guy in the background, though.
Hey.
His name is Fredo, though.
Hey. Fredo.